This video explains GUI scripting in Falcon. The UVI script allows you to manipulate the Falcon engine via GUI. First, insert script processor and default script in the event lane of the program editor. Next, create an empty Lua language source file in the folder where you saved the program and open it in the text editor. Create a folder for images. Prepare a 720 by 480 px background image. Specify the size of the image with the setSize function. Set the background image with the setBackground function. Make performance view function displays the GUI in the info tab. Open the source file from Falcon. The background image is now displayed. Enable the right side button to watch the script changes and reflect them immediately. Next, I will display the octave knob. Before doing that, prepare variables for the key group and analog stack. The first child node can be referenced by square brackets 1. Create a knob with the knob function. See the UVS script documentation for the meaning of the arguments. Look at the analog stack section of the elements and parameters page. You can know the range and the integer or float types of analog stack parameter values. Set the size and position of the knob. Specify the knob image. The knob image is an animated image like this. The octave knob is animated in 5 steps, and the volume knob in 31 steps. Set the current value using the setValue method. The knob is now displayed. Implement callback functions. When turning the knob, set the value with setParameter method of analog stack. Mute oscillator 2 and check the sound of oscillator 1. Similarly, generate a volume knob. The volume knob has a float type value. I downloaded these knob images from Knob Gallery. Next, create the on/off switch. You need separate images for the on and off switches. It is working well. Similarly, create the controls for oscillator 2. That's all for the basics of GUI scripting. Finally, replace the UI images with high-quality images. Wah 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 w Let's switch to the info tab and play. In the next video, I will make these UI images using Blender.